just arrived to Mount Kaputar. We're doing the Governor's Summit and it looks like we're having a bit of an issue with the car, a new one. We've got this piece and it's just smoking. Looks really hot and it's smoking. So, but you know, we'll find out. Oh my god, yeah, if you got the drone down there, that'd be incredible. Down by the mountain goats. It's beautiful out here.
There's another one at the top of that rock.
Oh yeah! Saying hi. Something that Tristan and I were talking about was that this place would be so incredible after a rainstorm, like right after, when the clouds are still misty and it's got this like dramatic effect, because there's a lot of this green moss here, and if you go hiking during a rainy time, that stuff brightens up so much and is beautiful. And the contrast with the like moody gray, dark blue with the green, it just pops. Everything looks more vibrant. And like, don't get me wrong, sunshine is amazing. And I love a sunny hike. But yeah, we were just talking about that because there's these things here, these giant pink slugs. And they're kind of like the ones in California that are yellow. Apparently there's only 21 species of slugs. And here they have these massive pink slugs. And we really were hoping to see them, but they only come after rain. So if you're gonna do this hike, I'd recommend you do it. Like, check the weather, come after a good rain. But yeah, the Governor's Summit was a beautiful trek. A little bit shorter than what we like. Also, we're not used to just like hiking on top of a mountain. We're used to hiking up the mountain, but we loved it and would definitely recommend.
I can honestly understand why people don't go on trips, because there's all these things that always go wrong, and if you're not down for it, it can be a real bummer. The thing with our car, it's not a surprise, because the last big trip we did, went off-roading hardcore, and we kind of got stuck on a road where we couldn't turn back around, and it was a crap road. The bottom of the Honda hit the ground probably 7 times, and honestly I didn't think we were gonna even get out of there. So the fact that we did was a blessing, and we didn't have any problems after it. So I'm not surprised that for this trip something came up. Like, it's just a matter of time with these things, and buying quality equipment, gear, is another thing, because we have these SD cards that just stopped working, and all of our stuff that we've been filming up till now is just erased. So it's a bummer, because we didn't even get the chance to do anything with it. And for me, it's a real hobby to create and share stories, and I really enjoy the art of storytelling. And so the fact that I don't even get to do it is a bummer. And your water bottle starts leaking, like all these little things, they really add up. But at the same time, like, I feel like this is how you really learn your ability to troubleshoot and work through problems and maintain a strong positive attitude, because it's times like these that you just want to like get really mad and reactive. The more proactive you can be, the better. Yeah, so all this being said, I totally understand why people just don't go on trips and don't travel. It's a lot of work. It's not just like everything works out magically. Like, you have to work for it oftentimes. So if you're not down for an adventure and everything that comes with an adventure, then I totally understand why travel isn't for you and you'd rather watch other people travel and watch their stories and videos. I never really understood that before. And now as I, you know, gain experience, I'm like, wow, it's a lot of work to travel and film it. And travel alone is a lot, like the challenges that come up. So I understand why people don't do it. I understand why people don't even do weekend trips. It can be so time consuming, like to pack up the car, to do the trip, to do all the driving, to set up camp, and then come back, unpack it all, clean the car, like it, and then all the wear and tear on the vehicle as well, giving the time off work if it's a an extra day, or just being tired when you come back and needing time off from work because you're tired from your trip. It just kind of defeats the purpose. So yeah, that's just my 2 cents.
By the way, if you're not following me on Instagram, definitely go check out my posts over there. These are just a few behind the scenes of our Badlands trip, and we have a lot more like this.